Yeah, it's been pretty crazy. Still a kind of surreal moment for me. Still, you know, just taking it all in. But I like to have that. I like to call it the 24-hour rule. You know, enjoy it for 24 hours and move on to the next thing, which is Michigan. So.
How many phone calls have you had or text messages?
A lot. You know, from family back home, from friends all over the place. It's been pretty hectic. Right, you know, it's just a big win for us, and, you know, we just have to move on and prepare for Michigan. Like I said, you know, it was a big one for us, so we just got to take, you know, all the momentum into Michigan and, you know, play our game.
You watch Sports Center? You see the top
look? Yeah, I saw that.
What was that
like? It was pretty cool. It's always been a dream of mine, you know, to be on Sports Center one day, so to see that, I mean, it was a humbling experience as well. Yeah, like I said, it's like a dream come true. You know, like I said, it was always a dream of mine to, you know, be on Sports Center and to finally have it come true. It was pretty crazy, but I mean, it was a team win, and there was so much, you know, other stuff that went into that whole game that enabled that play to happen. So, you know, like I said, great team win.
Can you talk about what your design was on that play? You run down the sidelines to get in the end zone, just kind of take us from the moment of the snap.
Yeah, so we kind of did like a little bunch right formation type deal, and we have Quincy, the point guy. He kind of goes down there and stands and gets the end zone, obviously, and we have a couple guys that kind of just surround him for a tip. So Quincy will try to go up and try to tip it to one of us. And I don't think it was Quincy who tipped it. I think it was a Northwestern defender who tipped it backwards. But all their defenders kind of went up to the goal line. So I was just like, I was behind all of them, and I was like, oh, man, the ball gets tipped backwards. This is going to be a big play. And, you know, they got tipped backwards, and I was just fortunate to be standing there and be able to make the grab.
You leaped up, and it kind of looked like you kind of blocked out the Northwestern defenders.
Yeah, you know, like I said, they all kind of rushed towards like the goal line, and I was 4 yards, you know, in the end zone, I believe, and you know, it just worked out perfect where they were all up front, and I was the only one in back. So when that ball got tipped back, I didn't really have to try to pull away from anybody. I just had to grab it as fast as I could.
How many times did you say that you guys have actually practiced that
play? I mean, we usually go through it in our walkthroughs, you know, our 2 minute. At the end of the game, kind of last plays type deal, we tend to go through it a couple times. So it's just crazy that we, you know, actually had to run it and it worked out.
Jordan, where's the ball now?
I actually had to give it, you know, to the equipment guy to hold on to just for compliance issues.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
You don't get to keep it?
Well, he'll hold on to it for until I'm done here. Yeah, you know, you just got to move on and keep working hard. You know, I just keep preparing. You know, again, with Jamal suffering from injuries, that gave me an opportunity, and I just got to keep preparing and be ready for the next opportunity and just continue to get better and never be satisfied and just continue to work and work and work. Yeah, I think like Larry the Cable Guy tweeted at me or something. I may have seen, and that was pretty cool.
Jordan, you're quite a bit younger than Ron Calloway, like a pretty old guy. How's he looked at on the team? How's he viewed, you know, as a guy who's never really been in the running to be the starter, but he's always been a backup? How's he viewed?
He's still, you know, viewed as a veteran, you know, top guy there. We need him. So you know, he's a great guy, and we all look up to him because he's still a leader, quarterback, and he's a real smart guy, and he knows his football. Yeah, well, I knew he had a 50 yards. He I know when he threw it, he kind of just his whole body kind of flipped forward a little bit. But yeah, I mean, it was impressive. He's got a cannon.
What's the best nickname you've heard from the
Westerkamp. I mean, it's ridiculous. I keep hearing a whole lot about the mustache thing. I'm going to have to pick the catch. That's definitely, in my opinion, better.
You talked about Jamal Dean. You guys have a lot of them on the offense. How important is it for your entire offense to try to get healthy heading into Michigan, or as healthy as it possibly can get?
Yeah, it's definitely important. When a guy goes down, it's just the next guy step up and be ready. You always got to prepare for the opportunities and someone goes down. So, hopefully we'll be able to get some of those guys back soon.
I feel like I understand one plays a position, but do you think it's important to have as much help on that offense as possible going into the last 14 games?
Oh, definitely. You always want your team to be healthy, but it's just the nature of the game. Injuries happen, and you just expected the next guy to step up.
Referring to that play as?
Hail Mary, basically.